Hi, I'm Bill Wallace. We're going to do some kicking today, but we're going to only use three kicks. The side kick, the roundhouse kick, and the hook kick. The reason is I've got a bad knee, and I want my weapon to be as close to my opponent as it can actually be. So if I'm fighting you this way, I don't want to throw a kick with the right leg. I want to throw it with my left so I can reach you, I can be close to you, and I can do the damage that I need to be done. You're using the three kicks, the side kick, the roundhouse kick, and hook kick, because those three kicks cover all three angles. The angle coming straight in, which is the side kick. The angle that comes to the outside or the inside, depending on my opponent, is the roundhouse kick. My power kick outside of the side kick is my hook kick. That comes the opposite way, so I don't have to worry about throwing a rear leg roundhouse kick or a spinning back kick. So those three kicks that I use cover all three angles. Then I have the different heights that I use from using those angles depending on the target that I pick. Most important of all, we're going to use snap, not power, not strong movement, but speed in our movement, quickness in our movement, deceptiveness in our movement. Why? Because not all of us are big and strong guys. Not all of us are fast. I don't throw power. I throw speed. I try to get you, my opponent, to walk into this movement. When you walk into this, I don't have to be strong because you do all the work for me. Understand how we can set these techniques up. Even though it's a roundhouse kick, even though it's a simple side kick or a little more complex hook kick, those three kicks, when they're done in combination and they look exactly the same coming at you, it's very difficult to defend against. Why? They all three look exactly the same. And that's what we're going to work on so we can help you be more deceptive, be sneaky, create those openings, and score on your opponent. Before we work our kicking techniques, I want to really emphasize the flexibility that's involved. We work all kinds of flexibility in our classes and for our hamstrings, for our adductors and things like this, but what I want you to actually think about now is adductor flexibility. Why? Because we need to get that knee up nice and high so it gets over our opponent's guard, around our opponent's guard, or the other way, hook around our opponent's guard. Don't ever go through a guard. Why? Dissipates the power, dissipates the speed of the movement. So I like to go around and like to have the knee be high so I can use that knee as a fulcrum, as an advantage point. So what we're going to do is just kind of warm up with me now. Just kind of circle the hips nice and easy. Just nice and easy. Just reverse it going the other way. Get that synovial fluid in that hip joint nice and relaxing just to get it to relax. Reverse it again. Good. Arch your back a little bit now, stretching that top edge of the quadricep, the iliopsoas, the sartorius. Stretch it out. Good. Good. Circle again. Reverse it, going the other way. And reverse it again. And reverse it. Arch your back again. Good. Circle a little bit. Okay, now the hamstring. Just to loosen them up a little bit. Knuckles on the floor. Just nice and relaxed. Just hold it here for the count of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now just bend over a little bit more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, grab the back of your ankle. Just pull down a little bit. Just a little bit. We're just warming up now. Pull down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good. Now, feet about double shoulder width apart. Just nice and easy. Relax a little bit. Work the head to your left knee and to the right knee. Left knee again. And the right knee again. Left knee one more time. Right knee one more time. Now take care of the hip joint now. Take it out to about this position here. Don't take it too far. Kind of rock back and forth a little bit. Toes are up and sit down. Nice and relaxing now.
Nice and relaxing.
Okay, now, if you've worked with my stretching tape, if you've worked with my stretching regimen, my stretching ideas, we're going to isolate this adductor muscle because it's the most important muscle that we're going to stretch today. Okay? Hands are behind you, nice and easy now. Right foot doesn't move. The left one is the only one that moves. Okay? With me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 1. Just a little bit wider. Nice and relaxed now. Remember, don't stretch real hard. You just want to be relaxed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 2. A little bit more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 3. Just two more. Two more. Nice and easy now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 4. Last one now. Just nice and easy now. Just nice and relaxed. Hold this one for 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30. Hands in front now. Just kind of roll the hips over. Relax those joints. Good. Just relax it around a little bit. Get that relaxation. Good. Scoot back. Bring your left leg up. Work the back of the knee a little bit. Back of the leg a little bit, the hamstring group, get it relaxed. Right knee up now. Work the back of the right leg. Bring your left knee to your chest. Bring your right knee to your chest. Hop up. Or get up any way you can. Circle the hips a little bit. And we're ready to go. You ready? Okay, now, take the simplest kick first, the roundhouse kick. Why do we want to throw the roundhouse kick? Simply because it's my speed movement. How I set it up? I make you block. I make you react to it. Why? Because I'm sideways to you. This is the stance that I fight in. I need to have a weapon that makes you react. That's a speed weapon for me that I do not give away. So I can come up with this reason, out, back, and down. So when you defend against it, somewhere else there's an opening. Marcus, can I ease you, please? Take your left side forward fighting stance. Now, if you look at this stance, let's say the elbow's a little bit lower. This arm is a little bit lower here. You notice he's taking away most of the targets now, the chest and stomach area. But what I need to do now is come around. This block might be right here. But I want to be able to come around that block so it can come to that reason. If he blocks that thing, it's defended against. If I throw the kick there, I want it to come underneath his movement. If I throw the side kick or the hook kick, we're not worried about yet. But the roundhouse kick comes around all these weapons, all these defenses. Because now he has to move the weapon. He has to move the defense to create an opening for me. First kick is the roundhouse kick. Korean, Doryochucky. Japanese, Mawashigiri, excuse me. Now, I like to use the belt to start with. I have two ways of covering the distance. If Marcus and I are sparring, this is about the distance you spar from. If I'm going to throw the kick at Marcus from here, somehow I got to get to right about here. He's not going to let me do that. So I use two ways of covering that distance. One is an obvious here I come, ready or not. The second way is a speed movement, a sneaky movement. We're going to do the sneaky movement first. Why? Because it's a little more difficult to do and a little more involved in the movement itself. Number one, if I'm in this position here about where we're sparring from, when I throw this kicking technique, two things have to happen. Number one, I have to move. Number two, I have to gain distance. I have to get closer to him, right? So if I have to come here and I go, yeah, one of these things, what's the first thing Marshall's going to do? He's either going to back up, which is the easiest thing to do, or step forward and punch me in the nose. And I like my nose exactly where it is, so I don't want to have that happen. What I can do is become sneaky now. Because if I'm right here, and I come to this position right here, you noticed I brought my feet right smack together in the middle. Marcus didn't shift at all, didn't move back, didn't lean, didn't go, whoa, what's going on? Why? Because I didn't get any closer to him. If I do this, he's going to maintain that distance. If I do this, he's going to shift. But if I don't do anything, what's to make him move? So I just do this, boom. I haven't leaned one way or another. All I do now is kick. You noticed it reached. Why? Because if I kick from this position here to kick, I have to lean back. I have to lean back. And as I lean back, I'll be further away. If I shift forward, he's just probably going to back up. So I want to have the kick be first in this situation. Why? Because I want to be fast. I want to be quick. So what happens now, watch, nice and slow. From here, together, together. Together. Now I'm stopping for our benefit. What I'll do now is I'll just kick. As I kick, what's the purpose of flexibility? It's not to kick way up here. It's to kick out. I don't want to have to stand here and kick somebody that's 7 foot tall in the head. I'd rather stand back here to where Marcus can't reach me and be able to kick him, because now I'm safe. So what I want to do is be right here together. Together, together. Now from this reason, now I just lean a little bit and throw that kick. Watch it again. From here, boom, boom, boom. Haven't gained any distance, but now I lean and make contact with my belt. Again, don't cover distance. What is this for? To cover up the movement. If you don't think I'm moving, you're not going to react to it. It's when you're waiting that you'll react. But the more you wait, the tighter you become, the more tense you become, the more you start to anticipate. So from here, nice and simple, one, two, three, boom. You notice my head didn't go back and forth. Just went up and down. That's how you can tell. Again, watch again. Belt level's a target. One, two, three, boom. Also, practice hitting the target. Don't do this. Don't move, Marcus. Where did I say kick? I said kick the belt. Some of you will do this. Okay. Wallace said kick the belt. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry, Marcus. Oh, I'm really sorry, Marcus. But what happens now is you're throwing the kick correctly, but you don't have a target. Marcus is standing like this, and I kick his arms or I kick his leg. What good is that? I want to kick to an open target. Why? So he has to block it. Or if I'm quick enough, I get it in, and he can't defend it. Because if Marcus is going to block this thing, and I come to here, and I come to here, boom. See, he's got to wait for me to throw it. I start already because the kick is on its way before he can react. If I do this, he's already got it blocked. Timing and distancing. Speed. Or better yet, quickness. Again, watch again. Marcus just stands there. One, two, three, boom. One, two, three, boom. Right to the belt. Now, where else can I take it? Of course, to the head. Because now watch. Marcus starts to block this thing. Good block, Marcus. Thanks a lot. He blocks it again. Boom. Because the minute this happens, there's the block. So use that. Because it's still part of simple kicking, creating openings. Tons of kicks in martial arts. Tons of kicks in karate, tons of kicks in taekwondo, tons of kicks in kung fu, lots of different kicks in Muay Thai, kickboxing, no holds barred. But what good are they if you can't score with them? Three kicks, and they're going to work great for me. Why? Because right now, what do I get Marcus to do? What has Marcus got to do? When I throw this, there's that block. Now watch the difference. Boom. Boom. What difference was there? The knee was here to start with, came out to about there, just a little higher. Did I lean back any further? No. Did I have to change my movement any? No. What helped me? A little bit of flexibility, but also getting my opponent to react. This little movement right here, creates everything for me. Because also, did you see what Marcus just did with his head? Now he's thinking. He wants to get that head out of there because, well, I just got him in the face once. Now he creates openings someplace else. But understand this little step right here. I can't emphasize this enough. Boom. 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 Wham. Don't stop. Don't do this. Boom. 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 And then kick, because once you start to do that, he'll react. If I'm here, he's got it blocked. I just very simply bounce off. Watch. You're going to block it, Marcus. It's just right here. Boom. 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 Wham. Bip. It's your knee. This is the knee. Boom. 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 Very simple. Kick to the stomach, kick to the head. Okay, we've used the speed aspect to cover the distance. Marcus takes his stance, and I'm just right here, boom, and the kick's into the belt, right? Now, what happens if I want to put a little bit of oomph behind that movement? I've already got my opponent to react to it. So what I can do now is I can use a lot of the basic movements from this position here, step, boom. What did he just do? What did Marcus just do? As I slid up the kick, I went, boom! I've already said, here I come, you son of a gun, right? And he's going, ah! And as I slide up to this position here, I've already told him, I'm going to kick. But I haven't told him where I'm going to kick. What I do now is I can start the kick low, making him defend low, making him react low, and then take the kick up to the head, boom, boom, wham! And in. Also, you see what Marcus is doing with the head? That reacts into another kicking movement. What's the exact opposite of a roundhouse kick? The exact opposite of a roundhouse kick is a hook kick. The roundhouse kick goes around. His block is here, it comes around. It comes around. The hook kick goes the exact opposite way. It hooks. It hooks. So, I can throw that movement from any particular way. When we're working, I'm working off of your reaction. I'm not making you block this. I'm not making you do this. I can't. But I can watch how you block. I can watch how you defend and work off of that. That's why I think I was so successful over the several years that I was champion. Because I know what Marcus has to do to block it. I know what he has to do to defend against it. I know what openings are created. Again, watch. I start off here. Boom. Getting that kick in there. Boom. Boom. Now I can stop. Fake, fake, boom. Same movement. What's different between the first movement and the second movement? Nothing wrong here. 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 Same. But how about this? Boom. I'm making a block. Now I stop and I look at it and I say, here goes. Boom, boom. And he's going to block that thing. Why? Because he says, oh, here it comes. That doesn't mean I have to throw the kick. All I do is keep going. Hey, hey, boop. There's the movement. Now, watch again. Boom, boom. The head's going away. So it dissipates a lot of the power of that roundhouse kick. There isn't any power in it, but it dissipates the force of the kick. Now the speed, still there, but now it takes a little bit off of it because Marcus has moved the head. What I try to get you to do is help me as much as you can by walking into it. If you walk into it, I don't have to be strong. I don't have to be hard. You go, ooh, let me help you. And that's what's going to happen. Same movement now. Step. See what Marcus is doing with the head? Watch again now. Now I change it very simply into a hook kick. Step, step, boom. And right there. So it's like, hey, 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 boom. Watch again. I step up. There's the block. I step up. There's the block. I step up. Boom. There's the kick. Watch again. Watch the knee. Step. There's that movement. Step. There's that movement. Now watch the pivoting of the knee. Not the hip. Not the hip. The knee. Because I don't turn the hips. If I turn the hips, I can't throw one of the other kicks. The knee pivots. Boom, boom. And in. So that's what works. Slower. Watch the knee. And in. To get you to move into the technique. To create that opening. Now, that's off the roundhouse kick. Looks exactly the same to Marcus. Why? Because I'm throwing a kick to you. Marcus, over here if you would, sir. Right there. Right there. See how the leg is there? See how the leg is there? Now watch on his right side, your left side. Right from there. It's hey, 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 hey. Boom. So basically, it starts as a roundhouse kick, finishes as a hook kick. What's easier to do? For me, just a plain hook kick. But as I step for the hook kick, Marcus can see it coming. As I throw the hook kick, he can move his head. See what he just did? As he moves his head, he's out of the way. But what did he do to defend against it? What did he do to defend against it? Where'd the head go? I start to throw the kick slowly. The head comes right towards you. Why? It doesn't go straight back with it. Why? Because the foot's out here. Still within range, maybe. So if he moves the head that way, that's further away from the weapon. But now what's it closer to? The roundhouse kick. Remember, we're still working with the roundhouse kick, right? So if I start here, he does that. Now all I do is pivot it back. There's the roundhouse kick. And he walks dead into it, goes, I got it. It's just like Muhammad Ali's bolo punch. Remember this? Hey! Hey! Right? Wallace doesn't have a bolo punch. I'm sorry. But he's got a bolo kick. Why? Because I get Marcus to think what's happening over there. If there's something over there, you still look at it. It's a flinch. It's still a flinch. So we use that. Just make it stick out of there. Go, and here, boom. There's the movement. How you create that movement? Making him react. The roundhouse kick is my jab. It's my quickest technique. It's my fastest movement. It's the most simplest for me to throw. Why? Because I just go, boop, and it's there. I don't have to clock it. I don't have to wind up. I don't have to turn, pivot, or do anything. I just throw the kick. It's up to him to block it, defend against it, whatever it is. And if it's that quick and I don't have to move, he's got to anticipate. When he anticipates, somewhere there's an opening. I can't emphasize that enough. There's always somebody out there faster than you are. There's always somebody out there stronger than you are. People out there with better technique, more flexibility. Some of them are even smarter than you are. But nobody ever, ever, ever has to be sneakier than you are. Think about golf. Would you rather be lucky or would you rather be good? I'd rather be lucky, because then the ball can fall into the hole and I wasn't aiming for it. If you're good, you're trying to get it there, and chances are you won't. But if Marcus is taking his stance here, and I step here for this hook kick, and he just moves that arm and that head just a little bit, what's he thinking about? He's thinking about the hook kick. He could care less what's happening over here. Why? Because there's no thought pattern there. And that's what I like. Because when I cock this thing here, and I get that reaction, boom, there's the movement. There's the movement. Very simply, here, here, just on the outside, here, here, boom, then there's the kick, and then moving it back. Using that roundhouse kick to score. Using the roundhouse kick off of other movements to score. Now, what happens if Marcus faces the other way? What's he taking away from me? What's Marcus taking away from me right now as far as competition goes? Sure, I can still kick here. Chances are it won't be scored very much. Why? Because it's more the back than it is the ribs. More the back than it is the kidney area. Chances are he'll drop his elbow and I'll go, ugh, because I catch the elbow maybe. But what I can do now is I can create. Watch how this happens. Marcus is on this side right now. I can still throw the roundhouse kick. Boom. And he still blocks. Boom. He still blocks. Boom. Then I can throw the kick to the head. Why? Boom. From this position right here. Why? Because when I do this, see, the block's already started. And I haven't thrown a kick. It's just right here. Boom. 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 Right in. Again. Boom. Boom. Nice and simple now. Boom. And in. Sorry. Now what? In this position right here, he's taken away most of my roundhouse kick maneuvers. But he's opened himself up for one real, real great technique for me. One that most of my knockouts occurred with, called a side kick. Because with this elbow in this position, I can get the kick here before he can drop the elbow. But as he drops the elbow, watch what he has to do. See, he pulls it into himself. Understand this as you're fighting, as you're sparring, as you're competing. Know what he has to do to block it, to defend against it. So as he blocks this thing, he pulls it into himself. So he helps me. He helps me. I can do that two different ways now. My sidekick is always rib height, stomach height, chest height. I don't throw the sidekick to the head. Why? It has to travel too far, and as I throw the kick high, my balance might be off a little bit. The hook kick, the roundhouse kick, I throw to the head all the time because I maintain my balance because it's coming around, not going straight out. My sidekick is my reverse punch. My sidekick is my defensive self-defense movement. Why? Because I'll cut you in half with it. Like I said, most of my knockouts in the kickboxing field was with a defensive sidekick. Defensive. I'm fighting, this guy comes in, wham, and it's there. Hard to fight when you can't breathe. Real difficult. So what happens now, we're going to use this. Can I get you on this side, Marcus, if you would? Now watch what happens. Watch him block this movement. The blade comes up, boom. See how he's trying to force it through? But if I throw the kick there, boom, it's already there. It's already there and down. So what happens now, I have two ways I can do this. From here, remember our speed movement again? Boom. Nice and simple. Boom. Nice and simple. Boom. Nice and simple. Now, but see, that's not strong. Like I want to cut him in half. So now what I can do, I still do this. Stop. Now watch as I step. Very simple move. Most of you are either stepping behind or stepping in front of. If I step in front of, can I throw the hook kick? Very difficult. If I step behind, can I throw the roundhouse kick? Very difficult. But if I replace, I'm still perfectly sideways. So I can throw my techniques. I'm right here. If he decides to hit me back, I'm gone. Why? Because I maintain my balance. Very important. Remember, I'm on one leg for a little while. I'm on one leg, maintaining that balance. How many of us want to do this? Ay-yah! Do you want it to be his turn? Never. Sparring is no fun when it's his turn. It's only fun when it's my turn. So, the stepping movement. There's my target again. I step to get my body driving forward. Step to get my body driving forward. See, the head comes forward now. Now he has to react to it. Boom, boom. There's the movement. See what happens? Boom, boom. I'm already cocked. Leg's not up yet, but right from here, boom. There's the movement. So it's from here. Watch again. I step, boom, boom, wham, and in. You notice I'm still sideways. Not this. No. And not this. Because if he decides to reverse punch with his left hand, what can I do? I'm stuck. I can lean back, but now what can I do? But if I'm sideways and he punches, look at that. And now look at all that stuff. Boom. There's that movement again. Watch again with me now. Just try it. Get up and try this. I know you're watching, but get up and try this. Step. Why? To get my body driving forward. Step, slide up. See, I've already pivoted. Now, the knee comes up and out. Back and down. One more time. Step, slide up, and out. Back and down. Boom, boom, wham. Boom, boom, wham. Boom, boom, wham. There's the movement. No faking, no speed outside of the driving, but it's straight line. It's a good, strong reverse punch. Okay? Now, what can I use off of that thing? I can't use it very well. Why? Because if he keeps his arm down and I score on it or I throw the sidekick to the arm, he's going back. What combination can I use? What combination can I use? None. He's gone. But what I can do is I can start to throw it and I get that to happen. I get that to happen. And then I can very simply work off of it. But here, boom. And throwing that roundhouse kick. Slowly. Step. There's the movement. Step. There's the movement. Now watch slowly. Step, step, boom. And boom. Just like the roundhouse kick. But now he's got to worry about right there. What else can I use? There's that. There's that. And the hook kick. All the kicks work together. He's got to defend. When he defends, somewhere there's an opening. All I have to do is find it. Or better yet, create it. Let's reiterate. On the roundhouse kick, speed. I'm not trying to do damage. I'm trying to make you react. I'm trying to score. If it does damage, that's wonderful. If it doesn't do damage, which is fine because it sets something else up because you have to block it. My sidekick has always been my favorite weapon. Not my fastest, not my most effective, but my favorite. Why? Because it feels really good when you nail somebody. And when they go, that's a good feeling. Marcus takes his stance. Now understand, two ways of throwing that sidekick. I'm right here. Boom, just like the roundhouse kick. Boom. Boom. Side kick right to the ribs and down. Stop. Stepping. Boom. Stepping again. Knees up high now. Why? Because once this happens and the foot comes higher than the knee, it becomes a push. It becomes a push. If I turn my hips just a little bit and the knee comes down, I can't throw it hard enough to do anything. Why? Because I'm going that way. I want to drive my entire body into my opponent. Not fall into him, but drive into him. Right there. Balance. Balance right there. See the knee? Right there. Protection. Now he's got to get over it, around it, or through it to get to me. It's a great defense too. How can I practice that without hurting my opponent? Arm is down here, nice and relaxed. This arm is right here to protect his face. What I do is I step up, I drive the kick straight in. Now, what's good about it, I'm not making hard contact. I'm just touching. Once I slide up and I touch to this position here, I stop and I maintain my balance. Why? Why? Because if I don't have my balance, two things are going to happen. Number one, I'm going to fall back, which makes the kick ineffective. Or number two, I fall forward. And if he blocks the kick, whose turn is it? No fun being his turn. So this arm is nice and relaxed right there. Now just watch. I step, slide up. Knee comes up, boom, right there. That's as hard as I strike. Look at my balance. I can stay here for minutes. Back and down. So I come from this position. Now watch what happens. I'll do five of these, nice and slow. Boom. 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 See, just feel the balance. Boom. What happens if I lean back? What good was the kick? What happens if I lean forward? Whose turn is it? So, good balance. Knee comes up, straight out. Straight out. Straight out. Work that movement over and over and over. So it's second nature to you. You're going to use your front leg to do a lot of kicking. The roundhouse kick is very important. The side kick is probably utmost important because you can keep your opponent off of you with the side kick. But probably the most important kick that you have to have in your arsenal if you're a front-legged kicker is a hook kick. Why? Because Marcus is in this position. Absolutely no target at all with my left. Outside if I go to the head. It's a long way from here to there, though. So I have to be able to go here. I have to be able, if nothing else, to hook this thing in there. Why? Because I don't have a rear leg roundhouse kick. He's not going to let me go, excuse me just a minute, Marcus. Oh, yeah, he's gone. Thanks. But if I'm right here, now I can step. There's the hook kick to the chest. What's really good, too, is the knee does the work. I just throw the kick out here someplace. Let my knee go out and let it just snap back out and come back out and come back. So I throw it out towards you. Watch this. Marcus, move up right there. See Marcus's face? I'm right here. Foot goes out there. Watch. See where it is? There it is. Now all I do is let the knee pull it back. There's the movement. It's like a punch turns into a hook punch. A punch turns into a hook punch. Again, watch. From here, step, and then there's the hook kick. I can take it to the chest, even though this arm is right here. I can still take it to the chest with the heel. Why? What does a hook kick do? That's right. It hooks. It doesn't go around. It hooks over, under, sometimes even through. So it's from here. Now watch the hook kick to the chest. Goes around it, goes through it. Sorry. To the stomach. Almost like a side kick. Because if we're sparring here, let's say, and I throw the kick out this way, and I get stuck here someplace. If I try to do the side kick, something like that happens. I'm in trouble. So I can just throw it out and throw the side kick in this position. Just a modification. But that's what you have to do. Play with the techniques. Change them. Modify them. Use them so where they become effective for you. The hook kick again. Very simple. Step and up. Step and up. And then you just extend it out. Nice and slow. Step, step, boom. And it. Notice how it hooks. The knee's over the side. Left side, if you would, sir. Stand tall. Nice and real tall, real tall. What's in the way of my foot and his head right now? What's in the way? The shoulder. 99% of you, when you're practicing this hook kick, will hit that during the course of this practice. Why? Because you'll throw the hook kick not out here, but here. I need you to get a wide distance. Why? Because it hooks. Not a little one, but a big one. Why? Because I got to go around that. Marcus, if you can't tell, is a smidge taller than I am. So that's going to be in the way. Got to be in the way. So what I have to do is, rather than go over it, I go around it. Over it takes too much time. So what I can do is, if he's there, I'll touch right here with my toes. Watch what happens. See what happens? See what happens? If I try to get it in there, bounces off the shoulder. Whose turn is it? I don't even know where he's at. Ah, and he's going to nail me. So I go around it. Remember, straight in is my side kick. This side is my roundhouse kick. This side is my hook kick. I use it offensively, like we've just done. I can use it defensively. He comes in the jab. I lean back. He leans further in. Look at the head. I lean back. There's the kick. He throws it again. I lean back. There's the kick. He faces the other way. He throws the jab. Look at the face. Look where the nose is. Look at the teeth. Because now I can just wind up, wham, and throw it in there because he's dead in the way. So the first thing, he's doing one of those things. So understand the movement. Understand what he has to do to throw it. Left side again, if you would. Watch the hook kick again. Leg is going to go out about 45 degrees between you and Marcus, my partner. Then I just let the knee hook it. Step. Same movement. Step. Now watch. Step. And the hook. Step. And the hook. Step. And the hook. Understand that movement. How the leg works for you. How the knee works for you. How you can change positions. How I can start to throw the hook kick. Throw the roundhouse kick. Change from one movement to another. Why? The knee is my pivot. Not the hip. The knee is the pivot. Three kicks. The roundhouse kick, the side kick, and the hook kick. All of them come from exactly the same position. If Marcus is standing here, left side forward, if you would, right side forward, right side forward. If he's standing right there, once I get to this position, I start here. You notice Marcus hasn't done anything except lean back a little because he doesn't know where it's going. I can start the side kick, move into the roundhouse kick. I can start the roundhouse kick and move into the hook kick. Creating an opening. Creating a movement that he has to defend against. Why? Otherwise, I don't even have to throw the combination. I just throw the initial movement. I get a reaction. I get movement. I get a reaction. I get anticipation. The most beautiful thing about this is he's not trying to hit me back. Why? He's trying to figure out where the kick's going. He's trying to figure out where the movement's going. In my entire career, I've had 3 kicks: side kick, roundhouse kick, and hook kick. All my opponents ever had to do was to find out where I was kicking, when I was kicking, and how many times I was kicking there. The problem is, I didn't even know. Why? I work off my opponent's reaction. Look at his guard. If I start the guard here, I get a reaction. Boy, something else is wide open. If I go here, there's the movement. If I do here, I get a reaction. So understand exactly what your opponent has to do to defend. How you can throw that side kick, make him block it. Because this comes down. When this comes down, look at my head. If he blocks his side kick down, see the head? It comes down into whatever I decide to counter with. If I throw the hook kick, see what happened? Just the tenseness. Even though he didn't do anything, that happened. He tells me he's thinking about it. He's reacting to it. He's anticipating. And that's what's worked for me. Long time ago, I was quick. I'm an old person now. Older and older and older and older as time goes on. I've lost a little of the speed, but I still know what my opponent has to do to defend. So now, rather than be fast, rather than be strong, rather than be this terrible fighter person, now I'm sneaky. Because old age and deception will overcome youth and skill every time. Because we'll cheat. Because why? I get that reaction. And it's still my turn. Keep it up.